In this video, we're analyzing the motion of a hollow ball rolling without slipping down a hill. So we're told the ball rolls through a height of h, meaning its center of mass has dropped by a distance of h. We're reminded of the moment of inertia of a hollow ball that's 2/3 mr squared. And in part A, we're going to compute the speed of the ball at the bottom in terms of g and h. So this is an energy conservation problem, and I'll start from the very beginning and write E initial equals E final. And in my initial state, there's no motion. All the energy is potential energy. If we put the zero of the y-coordinate at the lowest position for the problem, that means we can call the center of mass y-coordinate h in the initial state and zero in the final state. And we have to remember that the gravitational potential energy is given by mg times the center of mass y-coordinate for an extended body. So we have mg, y center of mass for our initial energy, that's all gravitational potential energy. And then in our final state, that's all gone. It's all been transformed into kinetic energy. But that kinetic energy goes into two different places. Part of it is the translational kinetic energy, and that's 1/2 m times the center of mass velocity squared. And the other part is the rotational kinetic energy, and that's 1/2 I, the moment of inertia, times omega squared, where omega is the rotational speed. Now we need to relate that rotational speed to the translational speed of the center of mass, and this is done with the rolling without slipping condition. The center of mass velocity is equal to the radius of this ball multiplied by its rotational speed, and I'll post a link to the video where that was first derived. This means omega can be replaced with the center of mass velocity divided by the radius of the ball. So that's what we're going to do in the next step here. And while I'm at it, I'm going to replace I with its formula in terms of the mass and radius of the ball. So that's 2/3 mr squared. And we replace omega with v center of mass over r. And remember, we still have to square that. And notice what happens to the r's. I can cancel those out because I'm going to square that denominator. Also, if I go all the way back to the left-hand side of this equation, I see that my m's cancel out. In other words, the speed at the bottom is going to be independent of the mass of the ball. So what we have remaining on the left-hand side is g times the initial center of mass y-coordinate, which remember, we can just call h. And on the right-hand side, a 1/2 v center of mass squared resulting from the translational kinetic energy term. And then if I clean up these factors of 2 in the rotational term, I have a 1/3 v center of mass squared resulting from that rotational term. So I have 1/2 v squared and 1/3 v squared. So that's 3/6 plus 2/6. In other words, 5/6 v center of mass squared. And finally, we can solve for v center of mass by multiplying both sides by 6/5 and taking the square root. And this gives us v center of mass is the square root of 6gh divided by 5. Next, we're asked to compute the percentage of the kinetic energy that's in the rotation of the ball. And if we go back and look at our expression for the total kinetic energy, back here, where it was 1/2 v squared plus 1/3 v squared. Remember, the first term comes from the translational piece and the second from the rotational piece. So we had 1/3 v center of mass squared coming from the rotational part. And then the total kinetic energy after canceling the mass had reduced to 1/2 v center of mass squared plus 1/3 v center of mass squared. So to find the percent in the rotational system, we just have to clean this up. And we can cancel v center of mass squared out of it. And I have 1/3 divided by 1/2 plus 1/3. So that denominator we already know simplifies to 5/6. 1/2 plus 1/3 is 5/6. I can rewrite this as 1/3 times 6/5 and cancel a factor of 3, resulting in 2/5 or 0.4 or 40%. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.